This is the Wyze application for the Wyze Video Doorbell 2. As you can see, all of your Wyze devices will be listed on a single page. We'll talk about some of these extra options down here a little later. But coming up to the top, if we select the Wyze Video Doorbell 2, we are brought directly into the camera's live feed. There you saw, loaded up. Here we can see this is the active feed from my camera as of right now. If I double tap, I can zoom in. So you see digitally, it has zoomed in. And I can scroll around, we could see what's going on. And if I double tap, that will back it out. At the top of the screen right here, we could see the name of my device as well as the little plus sign. That plus sign means that I have the Cam Plus subscription service on this particular camera. Now, I will say that there are a lot of features that are locked behind the Cam Plus subscription. And when I come to them, I will point them out to you so that you know what you can do for free as well as what you have to pay for. If I tap on my image one more time, in the upper left-hand corner here, you could see that it is stating that there is 2K resolution. If I tap on that, I can change it to SD or 360. So if you need to lower it because of connection issues or bitrate problems. Tapping one more time in the upper right-hand corner, full screen mode, as you can see, it just changes the orientation of the camera. Down in the lower left, we have night vision mode. So right now it's on auto. If I select that, now it's on. You can see it changed it to black and white. Tapping one more time turns it off completely. You'll use this if you're using the starlight sensor. And I'm going to go back to auto. So it will use the ambient light to figure out, does it need to turn those IR lights on or off? We have our toggles for audio coming from the camera, or if I want to talk through the camera. Tapping either will turn everything off. If you happen to have both of them off and you tap the microphone, by default, it will turn the audio from the doorbell on for you. Coming down, we have our SD card. If I select this, this is going to bring me into a timeline of the SD card. Here you could see everything that's going on right here. And if we scroll, actually that's going into the early parts of today. So maybe I will load up yesterday and we'll come down here. So right there, you could see there is a timeline event that is a person was detected. Tap on there, it will bring me to that event. And there you could see me walking up. Now, these types of events, you will need Cam Plus for. Pretty much anything that has this purple icon, you need to have a Cam Plus subscription in order for it to work. If I didn't, this would just show as a motion trigger event and you would have to scrub through this timeline to look and see what that event was. From my SD card, I can take a photo. So that's taking a photo of what it's seeing right now. I can record video. So as I'm playing this event, I can record it and save a copy. And then over here, this is my album. This is gonna show me all of my saved videos. And from here, I can select, rewatch it, I can play it with sound, I can share it, I can delete it, or if I select edit, I can select multiple ones and delete or share. This does work the same for photos, so if you happen to take any photos, that's where they'll end up. And from our SD card, we can select go back to live. So now we're looking at the live feed of the camera. Just like we had with our SD card, we have the option to take a photo. So took a photo of my live feed. I can record the live feed to save to that album's location. Then moving over, I have responses. Several quick responses that you can tap to have the doorbell speak to a person on the other end. And they sound like this.
Can I help you with something? Hey, I'll be at the door shortly. Hello, please leave the package by the door.
I like the fact that they've moved where this was compared to the version 1. The version 1, you had to dig to find that. And it didn't really feel like a quick response to me. To the right of that, we have our albums, just like with the SD card. Here's where everything we recorded or took photos of will live. So there's two places that you can access that. Coming down, we have our events timeline. Now, again, as I stated, notice these purple icons. Those are smart triggers. You're gonna need Cam Plus for that. However, this wave icon indicates that that's just a motion event. And if I select this, there is my motion event. That is my mail person who is coming up to the house. I would not have known that that was a human event if I didn't have Cam Plus. Also, with Cam Plus, you have the ability to, over here in the corner, change the speed at which this will play. So you can go up to 4x fast. So if I do that and then let this play out, they walk up very quickly to the door. And from here, I can download, share, delete, jump to the SD card, which will bring me to the recording on my SD card because I have it recording 24/7, and then you can give feedback if this was an incorrect event. You also have the ability from the timeline to filter. So from here, you can filter. Again, notice person, pet, package, vehicle. These are subscription. Ring, sound, or motion, you can have for free. So if I want to, in my case, I want to just see people. I hit that, and now it's only going to show me the triggers that had a person in it. So that is a very helpful feature. And again, one of the reasons why you really need a Cam Plus subscription with the doorbell. I don't fault them for that, but just know ahead of time. That was everything for the doorbell controls that we can do. Coming up to the upper right-hand corner here, we have our settings sprocket. If I select this, now we get to change settings for our Wyze camera. Starting at the top, we have the name. I can alter the name simply by selecting that. We have detection settings. If I select this, this will allow me to adjust my motion sensitivity, my detection zone. If I toggle this, it's a grid view and you can select where you want. So these filled in areas are where my camera is actually detecting and then areas where it's not. So I generally have some plant movement right there, so I don't have that. And then the sky, I don't want to be notified, so I don't have that on. I have motion tagging, which is the green box that you saw around people and moving objects. You also have motion warning. Right now I have that set to none because my neighbors get enough of that from the smart drop box that I have as well. But if you select one of these, when the camera detects motion, it will either do the Wyze tone or that you're being recorded.
Hi, you are currently being recorded.
If you select either of these, you actually hear it on the phone, which I appreciate, but you also have the ability to change it from every 10 seconds or once per event or every 60 seconds. So you have some options to encourage somebody to not linger by your doorbell or let them know that they are actively being recorded. Here we have our sound sensitivity. If you're using this to trigger based on a sound event, you want to dial that in. I don't really use it, so I have it on a lower setting. Next, we have event recordings. Coming in, I have record for motion. Don't really care about sound. And then here, you can either do all events, which is recommended if you don't have Cam Plus, or smart detection. Smart detection is going to be person, pet, package. Need a subscription for that. Custom recordings, here I can say, okay, if you detect a person, record and notify. Friendly faces, that's a higher level of Cam Plus, which I don't have. Pet, record, notify, vehicle, I get a lot even with the grid setup as it is, so I turn that off completely. Package, on, and then you have interesting ones which I know are part of Cam Plus and every Wyze camera, but you have baby crying, barking, meowing, and talking. And you can choose, do I want to be notified, or do I want recording, or do I want recording and not to be notified? So I like the customization there. Next we have notification. Notice it had the big plus sign next to it. That's because of the subscription. I have notifications on and I can select manage, and that's going to bring us back to this page that we looked at before. Coming down, we have advanced settings. Looking at my advanced settings, I have my micro SD card. It is turned on and it is set for continuous recording. Events only will just give you those snapshot of events that happen. And realistically, if you are getting this doorbell, you're getting it because it has an SD card. Do utilize the continuous recording. Manage the SD card. If I select this, it will let me know, hey, this is how much is being used. I don't have the maximum card size in here. So what it's saying is, hey, when you reach your storage limit, we're gonna go back and we're gonna overwrite old footage, which I'm fine with. If you select format, that will format the card, erase everything on it. You can properly eject your micro SD card using that option. Here is another area where I can adjust night vision mode. So I have auto, on, or off, just like we had that little icon on the front page there. We have camera status light. This status light is the blue LED ring that's around the doorbell button. I keep that off only because I got enough lights on the front of my house. Kind of looks like a landing strip, letting people know, hey, something's going on over here. But I do recommend leaving it on only because it helps people know where to push the doorbell. Show timestamp, date and timestamp on all of your videos. That's helpful. Show Wyze logo. You could turn this on or off if you want the Wyze logo embedded in your video. And then record sound. If you live in an area where you are legally not able to record sound, that is how you would toggle that off. And then sync time is simply that. Sync the doorbell's time to your smartphone to have more accurate time. Coming down, we have chime. This will let us pick the type of chime we have. So in my case, I have a mechanical. You can have digital or none, but realistically, if you choose none, you're kind of using other devices to act as your chime. And then this I always appreciate, the do not disturb mode. So for whatever reason, if your significant other or somebody in the house is doing something and you don't want the doorbell to ring, this is a great option. You toggle that on, and even if somebody pushes the doorbell, no sound will emit in the house, even if you have a mechanical chime box like I do. Accessories, if you had any accessories to pair with the doorbell, simply come up here, press the plus sign, and then you can add a Wyze lock to pair with your doorbell, which is great. Rules will allow you to set up specific actions to happen if the doorbell is pressed, turn on a light, or send out a notification. Sharing, if I select this, I can share this device with somebody else. They will need their own Wyze account to do that. Device information, lots of sensitive information in there, but that's where you can check your firmware for your doorbell. And then Wyze support, if you ever have a problem and need to reach out to Wyze, this is where you'd go to start the help process. And then if you ever need to, you can restart the camera right from here. I have had to do this once, and once I restarted it, everything worked perfectly fine. And then our delete device, if we need to delete the doorbell from our overall Wyze ecosystem. Coming back to our front page very quickly, only to talk briefly about these options at the bottom. Home lists out everything that you have. Events, this is going to be an aggregate of all of your triggered events in one location if you have multiple Wyze devices. Monitoring, if you pay for a Wyze subscription that has monitoring, this is where you can come and manage all of that. Shopping, well, when I'm filming this just after Black Friday, there's a lot of deals that come up here. You can come in here, see what's going on. Your account will show you all of your subscriptions, account information, your home, services, friendly faces, if you pay for that, sharing, notifications, firmware updates, smart integration, rules, Wyze community, Wyze support, app settings, and about. The account page here, just think of it as if you have multiple Wyze devices, this will help you aggregate all of that data and information in a single location. And that has been everything that you can do for the Wyze Video Doorbell 2 utilizing the Wyze application.